I'll take you through some tricks to use Google Sheets to help you out with some voting methods problems. We're going to first use it in this video to count how many first, second, third, and fourth place votes we have for different candidates. This will use the sum if function, and I think it's a helpful function to learn for a lot of different applications. So I'm glad you checked into this video to see how it all works. You can copy and paste a similar problem like this if you have one, or you can just recreate a problem setting things up in the same places. Here I've got data for my different candidates, and this is all arranged as a preference schedule. So essentially we have 10 people with the same preference. They would rank G, their favorite, F second, C third, and B is last. 10 people had that same ranking. So that's 10 first choice votes for G. We've got 15 more first choice for G there and another 4 there. Clearly G is very popular. And I can add those up pretty easily, honestly, if I just use an equals SUM sum function, and I can hold command or control and just click the numbers above where I see G. And that will create a list and add those up. That's a way I can do it somewhat manually, but I would prefer to use this sum if function. So what we're gonna wanna do structurally is add the number of voters whenever we see a G in that row 2. The function is SUMIF, sum if. The range is asking for a range where you wanna look for the criteria. I want it to look in that range B2 to H2. Then I put a comma. The criterion is I just want to find a G. So I clicked in that cell right above, which is B7, where I have my G label. And then the sum range is right above it. And I actually could use entire row references if I wanted to. I could use row 2 and row 1. There, because it won't matter. There's nothing, it's not going to find a just plain old G anywhere else in there. And I can double check. I've got 10 plus 15 plus 4, that is 29. So that worked correctly. Now, could I fill this to the right? What do you think? Is it going to work if I fill it to the right? Imagine all of those boxes, those colored boxes, moving to the right with my fill. Now, it wouldn't. In this case, I can. It won't make a difference if I don't see a letter. So when I fill left or right, a B will come a C, then will become a D, and so on. So 2:2, it will not be affected by the left-right fill. Same with the 1:1. And that's partly why I wanted to use a reference that was an entire row instead of a limited range where it would actually move that reference. So I'm going to put that in as row 2, row 1, and the B7, we definitely do want to move to the right as we shade that or fill that to the right. We want it to look for now F. It's going to look for F in row 2, and if it finds it, it will find the associated number in row 1. It's going to add a 2 for that row, that column, and another 2 for that column. So now it looks like all of these are giving me correct counts. For my first place, my first place votes. Now I'd like to fill it down and have it do the same for second place votes. I gotta check my cell references and see if that'll work. When I fill it down, the letters won't change. Column B will stay column B, but the rows will progress. Row 1 will become row 2. Row 2 will become row 3. Now, as I move from first place votes to second place votes, the orange box should go from first to second. So that one we do want to remain free to move. B7, we do not want it to move. So I need to freeze that row into row 7. And you can just put the dollar sign in front of 7 to do that. You can also do function F4. Depending on your keyboard, you may or may not need to hold a function button when you hit F4, and that will toggle through different variations. we can fully freeze it in the row and column, which I think isn't a bad idea if you're not sure, but all we need is our row 7 to be frozen. And then we also want row 1 to be frozen because we need to maintain that the number we're counting is up there in row 1. So I will make sure that that 1 is frozen in. The autofill is now good to go. And I can refill this to the right and down now. And I should have now good counts for all of those votes that I have. And if you needed some totals, we could definitely find those quickly. We should have the same, highlighting those, we get 55. We should have 55 for all of those. Basically, every person voted for every candidate in some kind of rank order. So everyone's accounted for. Nobody left anyone off of their ballot. That's good as well. We can see the total number of first place votes, 55, and so on with those. So, all those are matching up right. If you want to add in something that finds the sum for you or the total for you, feel free to just add a total row or column. Once you hit equals, a lot of times it will automatically suggest just what you want. And so I can find all those marginal totals for each candidate's total votes or number of, people who voted first place and so on. Now, in order to win a majority in this election, we would basically just need to find that total number, that's 55, divide that by 2, and round it up. So 28 voters will be the simple majority here, or just over half for that. And obviously you can figure out which candidates dominated. Here we see G had the most first place votes. Although G did not have that many second place votes. For second place votes, F had the most. So if we had some kind of head-to-head system, or possibly we eliminated someone, those second place votes could then be a lot more useful to have.